We're now joined by Patrick Lucis, president of the Filipino community in Guam. Patrick, thanks for joining us.
Hello, Denise. Thank you for giving us this opportunity to speak with you all.
Now, how is the Filipino community preparing for the incoming typhoon?
Yeah, this time we are all following the orders and the direction by our local government. At this time, our governor, Liam Guerrero, has called for mandatory evacuation for all of our residents to take shelter. At this time, we are going to extreme wind warning is issued. There's tornado-like damaging winds, extreme dangerous. It's life-threatening. It's a life-threatening situation. And we advise all to take cover at this time. We're passing the word on to the rest of our Filipino community and residents to take shelter, shelter in place, find the room as the advice is to reinforce, shelter in a room that is reinforced and is away from windows. We are at the peak of the storm. It is very dangerous and life-threatening at this time.
Could you tell us more about the evacuation efforts? Is that being required already?
Yes. When we went into Core 3 and Core 2, condition of readiness 2, it was advised that we're expecting this storm to be a Category 5 super typhoon. It has been downgraded to a Category 4, but still very strong winds with 225 kilometer per hour winds up to 200 and actually up to 241 mile per hour winds. We are at the peak where the ice is passing north of us on the Rota Channel. So we expect to receive these winds in the next hour.
Now, how are the communication channels being established to keep the Filipino community informed about all the ongoings, or should there be any other announcements?
Yeah, at this time, we are in touch with our Filipino community. We have our officers and our board of trustees and board of directors from the different organizations reporting their situation from their location from around the island. At this time, we're all taking the direction of the government. Once the storm is over, we will be regrouping as a Filipino community in Guam, assessing what are the needs that our FCG can contribute to the government of Guam and those who are in need.
Are there any, I guess, specific concerns or challenges that the Filipino community is facing right now in preparation for the typhoon?
Well, challenges right now is in really just to get in touch with our community, see what is it that we can do to prepare. We are actually in the process of regrouping and preparing for the 125th Philippine Independence. We have switched gears. We are now, the Filipino community Guam has known to build a reputation with the government of Guam and respond to any support for any type of calamity, whether it be on Guam or in the Philippines or abroad. And so we are in the process. We will be regrouping after this typhoon and seeing what is it that we can do to support our Guam community. So we are in touch with many of our Philippine organizations, many of the Philippine partners. So we will be standing by to see after the typhoon.
Now, hopefully, of course, we're hoping and praying that there be no casualties or any of those things. But is there a contingency plan also? Can you tell us more about, I guess, to provide assistance and relief to the Filipino community in the aftermath of the typhoon? Has the national government here in the Philippines also reached out just in case?
The Philippine national government would be reaching out to our governor if there was any support needed. We are in touch with our Consul General's office, and so they are also standing by to see what is it that they can do in partnership with the Filipino community in Guam to support those in need. Usually after a calamity, our Philippine consulate's office do receive calls and numerous calls, and so we'll be working closely with them to see how is it that we can provide any kind of support. At this time, we ask all residents to, again, stay safe. There are reports of power lines and trees and landslides and flooding, and so it's very dangerous to be out there. We don't, after the storm, we advise not to drive out as there are still dangers that are in the road that need to be cleared. And so we will be in touch with our Philippine Consul's office and our government of Guam to see how is it that we can support.
Lastly, Patrick, do you have any idea of a specific number? How many Filipinos are currently residing in Guam right now?
So at this time, as of our January 2023, we have over 50,000 Filipino recorded residents in the island of Guam.
So that's Patrick Lucis, president of the Filipino community in Guam. Patrick, please stay safe.
Thank you so much. We thank you all for your thoughts and prayers, and God bless you all. Thank you.